The Morning continues right now on the Fox Business Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the Morning.
So Teresa Burney from Staten Island, she blows my hair out every morning, tries to do something with it.
Yeah.
And so I walk in this morning, and Carly says, Teresa's not here. Her cat broke its knees.
Yeah. It's kind of weird.
I said, what? Who even knew that a cat had knees?
I don't even know a cat.
Does a cat have knees?
I guess so.
Apparently. Huh?
We're all learning this.
How do you break your knees if you're a cat?
It tore all the ligaments in its knee, in both knees.
It was late on the VIG.
That's right.
Who said that, Warner?
No, Rob. Rob.
Yeah.
The guy right across the...
Well, late on the VIG. Well.
Could be.
And then we're doing psychos today, so so sometimes I want to know the topics ahead of time. And Dagan decides, she tells us her topic, but then she emails everyone else who she thinks is going to be on psychos today.
Oh.
And one of those people she emailed was poor Ashley Webster.
Poor Ashley.
And, of course, Ashley, the poor thing, he emails Megan and says, am I going to be on today?
That's right.
And I said, no, he's not. Yeah. But it has no reflection on Ashley.
That's very sad, though.
It's
just funny because Megan replied, just said, no. I mean, that was it. I'm like, oh, okay, thanks. That's okay.
That's what I told her. I said, just write back one word. No, don't offer an explanation.
No, that's fine.
But it had nothing to do. We thought you were terrific last time.
Oh, well, thank you.
It's
thank
just
you.
This time we're having Bill Evans.
Oh, well, very good.
So he's going to be on.
He's a psycho, all right.
He's on psychos along with the, along with True Psychos, Deirdre Imus and Dagan McDowell, and, of course, Nat Candido.
And do I feel bad that I made Ashley feel bad? No.
Hell no.
Well, I did. I didn't want Ashley.
Says Dagan with a smile.
And then now Rob and Tony appeared at the Tarrytown Music Hall and sold that bitch out.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Yeah, huh?
Yeah,
sold it out.
Yeah, yeah.
Sold it out.
Wow.
There were people fighting trying to get in. There were.
It's ugly.
And there's no better way to do a show than if it's sold out. So.
That's nice.
And they were, so that's good.
Yeah.
Good time.
Larry Flint shows. My Larry, how are you?
I'm all right. How are you?
Sound all right.
What will you be talking about?
I'm all excited about the new Apple Watch.
Now, this is the first new thing that I promise you I will not buy.
Good.
Oh, man. We're
wondering,
are you kidding
about
me?
That.
Even the $10,000 one.
The gold one.
Which I'd have been a sucker for in the 80s. I'd have had that in a heartbeat.
Yeah, top of the line is actually 17 grand. The most expensive one you can get is 17K.
Yeah, I'd have bought that in a heartbeat, so, but not now. So.
We'll see.
No. You've grown.
Any big sports stories, Warner?
Well, it's interesting. Talk about different routes. The Warriors and the Hawks became the first teams to win 50 games. The Knicks became the first team to lose 50 games.
Wow. Of course.
Three more teams make it to the NCAA tournament, which begins a week from tonight, by the way. And that NFL salary cap strikes again.
What happened?
Well, Darrell Revis. The Patriots said, we're not going to pay you $20 million. So he could become a free agent today. And you also have...
Is he going to be back with the Jets?
Well, no, they'll make a bid for him.
Oh,
it's a fight.
Yeah. I thought it was a done deal.
No.
No.
Oh,
no.
Where did I read that?
Slow down.
I don't know.
The Onion.
Well, this is probably where I read it.
Yeah. Could be Onion Sports.
Yeah, I'm the only person who reads The Onion and thinks it's real news.
Wake up.
What else going on? Anything, Warner?
Well, there's two other guys. Andre Johnson is the Texans' all-time leading receiver. They let him go.
What?
Somebody will pick him up. And also Julius Thomas, one of the favorite receivers for Peyton Manning, the tight end.
Hey, did you hear Stephen A. Smith said that he thought Chip Kelly was a racist, a coach for the Eagles, because he got rid of all the black guys and kept Riley Cooper. You know, he's a white guy talking about, dropping the N-word at the Kenny Chesney concert. So, and he's not that great, by the way, Riley Cooper. So, and the guys that got LeSean, whatever his name
LeSean was. LeSean McCoy.
He was good. They got rid of him.
Yeah, so. Running back, yeah.
So I don't know.
What's up with that?
Jeremy Maclin went to Kansas City.
Yeah.
But they're free agents, so.
Well, I'm just telling you what Stephen A. Smith said.
Not LeSean McCoy.
Not Sean McCoy. That was a trade, right?
Yeah. Well, what's the market gonna do today? Well,
the futures are down, but it was a good day for the markets yesterday. The Dow futures are off 105 points right now, but the blue chips were up nearly 139 yesterday.
What do you got, Ashley?
Well, interesting. eBay has given up trying to pull these items that are being put on eBay, where they profess to sell bags of air. So have you been following this? Sealed bags of air. You could buy a sealed bag of air from a Kanye West show. It went up to $60,000 before eBay says, all right, this is stupid, pulled it away. But now we have a Ziploc bag of air from Garth Brooks concerts. And for just $5, you can buy a bag of flatulence from Kanye. So I think that's a good deal.
Hey, good for the iMan, buying some air.
Yeah, hey.
Well, it would be a bargain for me, wouldn't it?
It'd be great.
And it's 11 minutes after the hour. What do you got, Bernie?
We have Bill Clinton is in the briefing. Bill Cosby, he put out a video. We have that. And also Suge Knight, the murder video, is out as well.
Oh.
You can see what happened.
Nice. Well, let's not be hating on my boy Suge. Suge was under attack.
That's right.
So as the video, I'm sure, shows.
Not really.
Well, it does show maybe some of that, but then, but then again, he killed his own friend in his frenzy to get away,
right?
Which he did not have to do to save his own fat ass. He could easily have not have killed his friend. The guy who was assaulting him through the window, that's debatable.
Well,
but running over his friend the way he did, that was brutal and unnecessary. According to what the video looks like.
Right. So there was some guy punching Suge Knight through the window of Suge's car?
Yes, this dude, Jones, he rolled up on him as he pulled in the fast food place.
Yeah.
Right at the driveway. The enemy, supposedly Dre's guy, Dre's making a movie about NWA. Suge didn't like the way he was portrayed in the movie.
Sure.
He's rolling up to talk about it. Dre's guy rolls up with a gun, and there's some sort of altercation at the window. It's not 100% clear that he has a gun, but it seems like somebody took a gun off him while he was lying in the street afterward.
What happened to him? Did he die too?
No, he didn't die. He was so Suge backs up.
Oh, just saw it on.
Right. Yeah. Suge backs up, and he runs over the dude with the gun because the wheel was turned at a certain angle because the guy was in the window. And then he goes forward, and he has plenty of time not to hit his friend, and he just rolls right over him and keeps going.
Jesus. Man, that's brutal. Look at that. Why do we have to show that?
Really?
Oh, we did.
But so, that is your guy.
What's the news going on, Colonel?
A couple of things that we can, we can talk about this Iran story in a moment, which is the big political story. But first, at least 55 people injured. Nobody killed, though. Amtrak train slammed into a tractor trailer that was stuck on the tracks in Halifax, North Carolina. The authorities say that a state trooper was helping the driver of the tractor trailer to try to make a left-hand turn across the tracks, but the truck couldn't make the turn. And authorities say during the several minutes the trooper and the driver were there trying to get the truck turned off the tracks, there was no warning, they say, of the approaching train. But again, 55 injured, nobody killed in that accident in North Carolina.
Man.
The Iran story, Vice President Joe Biden is not happy with his former colleagues in the Senate. He says he's offended that 47 Republican senators have written an open letter to the leaders of Iran saying any nuclear deal signed by President Obama could expire when he leaves office. Biden says it's an effort to, quote, undercut our president, circumvent our constitutional system. Now, this letter, which came out yesterday, written by a freshman senator out of Arkansas, Tom Cotton, here is how the president himself reacted to all this.
I think it's somewhat ironic to see some members of Congress wanting to make common cause with the hardliners in Iran. It's an unusual coalition.
Well, the front page of the Daily News says that they're
end of things.
The front page of the Daily News says they're traitors.
In case we are still on,
hello.
He says he...
We're on the air.
Yes, we're on the air. Everything's fine here.
We're on, apparently.
What?
We just can't hear ourselves.
We're on. Something happened to your headphones.
This is going to be great. We're on, but we can't hear ourselves. So this is just going to be a nightmare. We can't roll that way.
Can you hear me, Lou? Wave your hand.
Yep.
Okay.
We're on the air.
Because I have no juice in my headphones.
Me neither. So...
And I can't tell if the mic's on or not.
Yep, right, we can't hear
everything's on.
At all.
Is that something here, Bigfoot?
Might as well. Why don't we take a break and come back, you know? Oh, there we go.
There we're back.
There we go.
Oh, that could have been just a disaster.
Retired United States Army Staff Sergeant Travis Mills.
Yeah.
Yay, Travis.
Of the 82nd Airborne. He was here with General Lee last time. He's a wounded warrior, of course.
Yeah.
Talk about an American hero. Despite losing portions of both arms and legs from an IED while on active duty in Afghanistan, Travis is out there getting it done. Never give up, never quit. So Travis will be in. He's got a new deal he's talking about, so we'll talk to him. So, and I got a new trailer from Bloomer Trailers.
Oh, congratulations.
That Outlaw Conversion in Stephenville, Texas, built the inside, and man, it just did a fabulous job. And a Bloomer trailer, it's... one of them with three axles on it. It's a beautiful trailer. And everything was went great. Until.
Uh-oh, what happened?
Uh-oh. I called DirecTV.
Oh, man.
Who was the single worst company I've ever dealt with in my adult life.
Oh, Jesus, what happened?
You can't. I mean, once you get somebody on the phone, they're all very nice. Oh. But you can't.
Press one.
I've called them from my car because on my OnStar phone because my cell phone wouldn't work where I was or Joe's, and I used up 100 minutes.
Whoa.
Talking to these bastards, and you call DirecTV and you get an automated voice and they ask you for your account number. Well, who I have no idea what that is. Well, what's the phone number? Well, I don't know. Because I have DirecTV in New Mexico and Texas and here in New York. And so they ask you, that's an automated deal. So you give your phone number. And then they repeat it, the automated voice repeats it back. But that's never right, of course, because they can't understand. So it takes a. So then finally, you get somebody from DirecTV. God darn awful comment. I can't believe that anybody even has DirecTV. They're just. I mean, again, once you get a person, they're okay, but God, are they awful? They can't suck enough. So then, once you get a live person, they ask you the same information you already gave the automated deal.
That always happens.
Oh, always.
Always wonder why that happens. Oh, give us your name and your number, your zip code, and then they ask you again. Oh, the worst.
And they get on the phone and say, how are you? I said, I'm not very well. You know why I'm not?
How are you?
Because I have to deal with you bastards. I said, this is, you know, then there's dead silence because they realize they got this whack job on the phone.
You should be used to that.
Oh, I said, what are you people, nuts? And it finally, Grant Kay, the guy from Great West Trailers who supervised the deal, the Outlaw, I mean, he'd already gone back to Stephenville, which is 2.5 hours from Huntsville. He had to drive back to fix it, which he did. He was on the phone with them for 2 hours. Oh, man, I mean, man, do they suck. They are an awful, that's an awful company.
How are you, sir?
I mean, why do they advertise? They got the blimp with the DirecTV thing on, and then they advertise all the time? They should, you can't, particularly if you have more than one, DirecTV, well, that may be the problem. I have a bunch of them in New Mexico and a bunch of them here.
Not your average problem.
But still,
multi-state accounts.
I said, well, why can't I just, I said to the person, why can't I just give you my name and then and look it up that way?
Yeah, then they would know not to ask you how you are if you gave them your name.
And you can't, and then I had two televisions in the old trailer, two DirecTV receivers. And I had to disconnect the service on those. How do you think that went? Oh, and then you, She said, well, we can't tell what receivers they are, whether they're at the ranch in New Mexico or at the, or in Manhattan. Oh, son of a bitch.
Not good at all.
God, they are just, I'm telling you, they really suck. The people are nice once you get them on the phone because they don't, I mean, what are they going to do?
It's not their fault.
But that whole automated thing, is they got to drop that. Man.
Say operator. Yeah, when you call, just say operator.
Keep hitting zero.
Or press zero.
Yeah.
Over and over again.
Don't give them your information. Operator.
Customer service representative.
Attendant.
What's the news? Hurry up. We're going to have us.
Well, we talked about Iran, or we tried to. We had this letter that was written by the Republican senators. The other story is the U.S. ambassador to South Korea, Mark Lippert, who we had talked about. He's now saying he feels, quote, pretty darn good. This is the guy that was attacked with a knife last week during a breakfast meeting he had in Seoul. He's now been released from the hospital. He was released earlier today. He had his face bandaged up upon release, but his left arm also in a brace. Now, the man accused of attacking the ambassador said to be an anti-U.S. activist. And authorities are saying a French Olympic gold medal swimmer, Camille Muffat, and an Olympic boxer, Alexis Vastine, among the 10 people who died yesterday. Two helicopters crashed in a remote part of Argentina.
Oh, man.
These people are out filming a reality show, European show called Dropped, where two teams are left to survive some of the toughest terrains on Earth, and that's why they were in these helicopters, and which went down, and 10 people died, the two Olympians among them. So,
all right, 21 after our time for business news, sponsored by Pillars Boilers, and here with that is Dagan McDowell. Good morning, Ms. McDowell.
Good morning, sir. Triple-digit loss on the Dow futures after a triple-digit gain yesterday, and the Apple Watch, it finally got unveiled. Frankly, you already know if you're going to buy this thing or not. The only details you need to know, pre-orders start April 10th. The watches go on sale April the 24th. The cheapest, $349, and the most expensive configuration, according to the Wall Street Journal, is $17,000.
I'm not sure I want to wear something like that. It's got all that radiation on my body, do I?
It works through your iPhone, so it would be the radiation coming out of your iPhone. The wireless connectivity and GPS work in conjunction with your phone. People are saying this is a must-have fashion accessory. No, it's not. It's a digital watch. Let's get over it.
It's for losers.
But it is for losers and, I mean, geeks.
Does everything that your phone does.
Ashley, what's going on with you?
Well, I was just thinking about that. You know, I have a watch fetish, and that means I don't like to watch. I actually like watches. But I would not. I would not buy that. No.
What about the foot fetish?
Oh, that's a pretty good.
That says a lot.
More than
news for them,
I
guess. Yes. 22 after the hour. Here are some thoughts on the Apple Watch. This is our old friend Larry Flint. Good morning, Larry.
Morning. Well, just when you thought it couldn't get any better, comes the Apple Watch. I've never seen something this cutting edge since Dick Tracy's wrist radio. Great going, Tim Cook. It only took you 3.5 years to get back to 1930s technology. I guess that's what Steve Jobs meant when he said his last words, oh, wow, oh, wow, oh, wow. He was looking into the future but didn't get the whole statement out before he croaked. What he was trying to say was, oh, wow, oh, wow, oh, wow, I shouldn't have left that moron in charge. The first new gadget since old Steve went room temperature isn't even as cool as those Batman walkie-talkies you had when you were a kid. Who's gonna buy this thing? Aside from the Apple geeks who wait online for 3 days like they're Russians picking up a loaf of bread, how many people over 30 will be able to program this thing so it doesn't wind up flashing 12 o'clock like their VCRs? Oh, but on the Apple Watch, you can stream video and check email and take pictures and get directions. You know, everything you can already do on your phone right now. Just 10 times harder to see. I thought after shrinking everything, they were trying to make things bigger now. The iPhone 7 will be the size of your laptop. You'll have to wear it around your neck like your Flava Flav. Although that way you won't be able to see the screen. So how are you going to know what time it is? I know. How about you ask somebody? Or just pull down your zipper and stand in the sun and tell the time off your shadow.
Larry Flint here in the Iverson Morning Program, 24 after the hour. Time for sports, sponsored by Pillar Spoilers. Here with that is Warner Wolf. Good morning, Warner.
Good morning, Iron Man. Coming to you from the NJDiet.com studio. The Warriors beat the Suns. They go 50-12. The Hawks beat the Kings. They go 50-13. While the Knicks lose to the Nuggets 106-78. The Knicks drop to 12-50. Here was the end of the third quarter with the Knicks down by 32. Mike Breen and Clyde Frazier, MSG.
It has been a learning experience, to say the least, for Derek Fisher, as he's watched his team trail by 30 points or more for the ninth time this season.
They still have 12 minutes to distinguish themselves.
College ball, Gonzaga goes 31-2.
Wow.
And winning the conferences last night and moving into the NCAA tournament, Manhattan, Northeastern, and Wofford, which begins 1 week from tonight.
I got my notice from CBS Sports to join the bracket pool deal, you know. Yep. So, but I just can't. You don't. You never do that, do you, Warner?
No, I didn't go to any of the schools and don't bet on the games. I just have good games. I don't care.
Well, right? That's a very dim view.
Yes.
Of all this, but I shouldn't even ask you.
That's right.
But Tony will handle it this year again, I guess.
Oh, we're in good hands.
But giving Tony the money is not a great idea. So.
No.
Anyway, Bernie has got a briefing. What's coming up in a briefing, Bernie?
We have Bill Cosby, Bill Clinton, and did President Obama rip off Jay-Z during his Selma speech?
Coming up on 26 after the hour. Rip off Jay-Z.
That's right.
This is Jason Aldean.
Yeah, I'm chilling on a dirt road, laid back swerving like I'm George Jones. Smoke rolling out the window and ice cold beer sitting in the console. Memory laid up in the headlights has got me reminiscing on them good times. Turning off a real life driving, that's right. I'm hitting easy street on mud tires. Back in the day, Potts Farm was a place to go. Load a truck up, hit the dirt road. Jump the barbed wire, spread the word. Light the bonfire, then call the girls. King and the can and the Marlboro man. Jack and Jim were a few good men. Where you learn how to kiss and cuss and fight too. Better watch out for the boys in blue. And all this small town, he said, she said. Ain't it funny how rumors spread? Like I know something y'all don't know. Man, that talk is getting old. You better mind your business, man. Watch your mouth before I have to knock that loud mouth out. I'm tired of talking, man. Y'all ain't listening. Them old dirt roads is what y'all miss. I'm chilling on a dirt road, laid back swerving like I'm George Jones. Smoke rolling out the window and ice cold beer sitting in the console.
It continues right now on Fox Business.
One of Linda Fairstein's five favorite songs is Marvin Gaye's Sexual Healing.
Oh, it's got to be a joke.
That's got to mean she can't. This is a former chief of the sex crimes unit of the district attorney's office in Manhattan?
Mm-hmm.
What a sick broad she is.
Wow.
You think you know a woman.
Right.
Oh, my God. Travis Mills is coming up. Before we get to that, Bernie has a briefing here at 33 after the hour, and a briefing sponsored by Peerless Boilers. Good morning, Bernie.
Morning, boss, from the NJDiet.com studio. Selma was the 50th anniversary of the big march. All the cable network channels covered it, and CNN, they kept hyping up their drone plane coverage of it like a bunch of nerdy kids, and Jon Stewart was all over that last night and disgusted by it. Take a listen.
Can we get back to the historical commemoration of the march?
Tell us how this came to be.
I can tell you the whole team worked very hard to show people the images of that bridge. Wow, it really kind of remembers you 50 years ago, how powerful video was in terms of letting the country to know what was going on here. We talked to so many people who watched that drone go up, and they were happy that we were taking that look with that special piece of equipment. One man was so moved, he remarked, I have a drone! That one day... that one day sons of slaves and sons of slave owners could sit together and say, oh yeah, look at that. I have a drone!
And your other boy, boss, your new BFF, Larry Wilmore. who follows Jon Stewart. He was he got a hold of the tape that Bill Cosby released.
Oh.
Bill Cosby released it in his red silk PJs promoting his comedy tour. Very bizarre. And anyway, Wilmore was all over it. Take a listen.
Bill Cosby made a fool of himself again.
Now to Bill Cosby speaking out this morning, his first video message to fans since all those sexual assault allegations against him.
Yes, I'm going to be in Wheeling, West Virginia, Capitol Music Hall. 8 o'clock show, that's right. And you know I'll be hilarious. Can't wait.
What is wrong with you, Fat Albert? When you're accused of sleep-related crimes, you may not want to issue your statement in pajamas. Right? No. Especially not red silk pajamas. Those are like the Cadillac of creepy old man sleepwear. How does he not know this?
25 till the hour here on the Iverson Lemire program. This is one of Travis Bills. My favorite songs is one of my favorite songs, too. It was Luke Bryan's first hit. Great record.
Down where I was born was heaven on earth, where Flint River washes that red Georgia dirt. The sun sets slow and the stars shine bright. We raised cotton and corn, a little cane and kids. You either lived on a farm or wished you did. And Jesus always walked close by our side. Where I grew up, we rode in trucks. There's a lot about life we learned on the bus. How to lie, how to fight, how to kiss, how to cuss. The closer we sat to the back, the smarter we got. We were poor, we were ugly, we were all best friends. Wide-eyed, baptized, and still wanting to sin. Thank God we get more than just one shot. Where I grew up, we rode in trucks.
The Wild West of Talk Radio.
Imus in the morning.
Program retired United States Army Staff Sergeant Travis Mills is here. Then the 82nd Airborne, a Wounded War motivational speaker. He's got a video out. We're going to talk about that in just a second. Travis, despite losing portions of both arms and legs from an IED while on active duty in Afghanistan, is never going to give up and never going to quit. And one of the great American heroes that we produce in this country. Good morning, Mr. Mills. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you. Good morning, everybody out there. I definitely appreciate your time. And glad to be here and able to talk to you guys.
Thanks again for your marvelous service to this country.
Thanks. I like to tell people I didn't serve any more than anybody else. I just had a rough day at work. I zigged when I should have zagged, and it didn't end up good for me. But life's not over. I got a three-year-old, a beautiful wife of 7 years, and we keep on going. So it works out pretty well.
So you were here last time with Jenna Lee.
Yeah, well, she's great. Jenna Lee's phenomenal.
She's the best, isn't she?
Yeah.
And her husband, you know, life, of course.
Yep, we went to dinner with them and their son, Trace, and had a really great time Sunday night.
How's Trace? How old is he now?
6 months. He's doing great. He enjoyed the hand. You know, I kept him quiet when he was acting up, and they're like, oh, we're going to take him home. I spun my hand. He just started playing with that, and we were good. My hand died. The battery ran out, but it's okay.
Well, so what are you up to?
Well, recently we have been just with my nonprofit foundation. We did 2 weeks of the last 2 years did a week with families to come up to a retreat center that had a big vision of building and buying, but we had a camp we rented and a camp that we and, combined
it
with
needs
last
a lot
year,
of rehab, year,
but we're rehabbing it so we can bring families up to this retreat that are wounded, that are amputees, TBI, PTSD, and different things. We'll have counselors on station, but I felt like the best healing I got at Walter Reed honestly was with the guys and their family. So I'd go on these trips and learn how to snowboard, learn how to go downhill gravity bike riding, where I shoot down a mountain at 9,000 feet and my brakes are between my thighs. I gotta squeeze them in and I got my hands and this arm on and it's duct taped to a steering wheel and or a handlebars. So I felt like my best healing was with my family being there. So I'm trying to just bring that to Maine, bring guys and their families up. Because in Maine, where I live at, you might see one amputee every 3 months, yeah. And that's fine. Like, I'm not saying like I look for everybody that has an amputation, but there's guys that will sit in their house or not know they can do stuff and be reintegrated back into society. And my big thing is I don't live life on the sidelines. You know, I never go, never quit. I can go kayaking. I think next weekend I'm going snowboarding. My daughter's going to learn how to ski with my wife. She's 3 years old. And then the weekend after that, we have to go down to New Hampshire actually and go skiing and snowboarding again. So there's just really great things that are still out there for me. I drive a truck, a F-250, just like anybody else would drive with the gas pedal and brake pedal. And it's all stubbornness,
I guess. I'm happy to hear it's a Ford, by the way.
That's all I'll drive. I'm from Michigan. I mean, my wife has a Ford Explorer Sport, twin turboed, and we love them. So that's my take.
So how can somebody help you?
Well, I'll be honest. I definitely appreciate all the help. You know, just any little bit will help. We have a GoFundMe page, and I think you guys might throw it on screen. If you go to travismills.org, all the information is on my website, and everybody can check out what I'm doing. Please sign up for the newsletter. We'll keep you informed on all the progress of the building. And like I said, it's Elizabeth Arden's old estate. There's, you know, Red Door Spa. It's some really great property, and we got to rip it down to the studs, and it's going to host 6 to 8 families a week, hopefully all through summer, and then some through the winter time. But I want to reintroduce people to fishing, snowboarding, skiing, you know, just getting back out there with their families, as well as my, you know, like I said, my best feeling wasn't just from the doctors at the hospital and everything. It was talking with guys in the same situation. My buddy that lost both legs had a kid, Landon, who's 6 years old, who was my daughter's good friend, and her his wife Lacey talks to my wife. There's a group of like 5 or 6 wives that are on the same text message chain. They talk about nothing important, but it's helpful for all of them. And it's all about the families and bringing them up there and getting them out and showing them new ways to be active with each other.
So other veterans who are in the same situation you're in,
absolutely
just said that's got to be a great help too, doesn't it?
I think it is. I feel very fortunate to be able to accept what happened to me, be so open about what happened to me, and be able to talk about what happened to me. There's guys out there, I'm just one of so many stories, you know, but I'm not that sob story you need to feel bad for where I can put my head down and violin behind me. Honestly, I'm just Travis. I'm a guy with scars now. I'm not, you know, hurt anymore. I just go about my life every day, and I try to keep pushing forward. And with all the great foundations out there, Gary Sneese Foundation built my wife and I a house. He does that. And his foundation has done so much, and other foundations out there, Kelsey and I just wanted to give back. And this is how we decided to do it, and we've had great success the last 2 years. And now we purchased a property a week ago, and, you know, we're looking for all the help we can get, and all the information is on the website, and definitely excited. And there's naming rights to any corporations that, you know, want to be a part and contribute.
This is a DVD, right? The Travis Mills story?
That is. Yep, absolutely.
How do we get to that?
Right on travismills.org. Yeah, travismills.org as well. We have it. Nothing Hollywood about it. It's completely exactly what happened with the guys who got hurt with me. So the two guys got hurt with me. My two medics saved my life. Reenact all the scenes, the blow-up scene. The firefights are actually from my deployment, from helmet cams. And we don't make anything up. But I just brought that for you. I wasn't even going to bring that up. But I appreciate it.
Oh, okay.
Thank
you very much. Well, I wonder what I know. You're an inspiration to people like me and other people, other Americans.
Oh, thanks.
Who generally are thankful for your willingness to serve this country and sacrifice as you did. I mean, like, I was in the Marine Corps and played a bugle, so you know. So I mean, I would have gunned. I guess I'd have. Somebody had to wake people up, you know.
No, thanks for your service. I didn't serve any more than anybody else. Everybody signs up to do their part for their country, and that's great.
But you must be, I would hope that you're an inspiration to a lot of these veterans who are suffering.
I do try. At the hospital, they would ask me to go to the different rooms to meet guys, and when they were coming in, if they're having a rough time, talk to them. There was a double leg amputee that they asked me, one of the therapists said, hey, if you're going to come around 1 o'clock to the Military Advanced Training Center, the gym, and help a guy, maybe possibly help me learn how to go down steps or teach this gentleman how to go down steps. So, like, I went in there, and he was so afraid of falling, I just pushed him over because he was on, like, a harness system. I said, you're not going to get hurt. Let go of your canes. And he put his hand on me to walk down step, and his therapist was like, you're holding on to a quadruple amputee right now to go down a step. I was like, hey, man, it's fine. We all got to go from somewhere. And he'd been there 6 months longer than I was at the time. But, you know,
you're teaching them not to be afraid of life.
You can't be. You can't live. I mean, I've been in my mom and dad's house in Michigan. I'm from a great little city, Vassar, Michigan. And I was in the bathroom, and I was walking out to wash my hand. No one just said hand because I only have one. If anybody's like, only washes one hand, how weird. It's only because I have one right now. And it's a prosthetic. But I slipped on the tile. And I snapped my foot clean off. I was like, Mom, I just broke my foot off. She came in frantic. What do I do? And I said, I just really got to call the process and get a new one sent in the mail, Mom. That's really it, you know. But I do try to help. I was fortunate enough to go up to the Boston Marathon victims 2 weeks after the incident and meet with them, go room to room, and met about 12 at the Spalding Rehab Center. So if my story helps somebody get through something, I love to do it, and I don't think that I have any more problems than anybody else. I might look like I have some problems, but I really don't.
TravisMills.org. God bless you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you guys having me on. This is awesome.
Anytime.
I just don't look as good as you guys. I was trying so hard. I need to get some sun, maybe.
No, you look pretty good. So. All right, TravisMills.org. Do this. 10 minutes down to you. One of the most obnoxious commercials on the planet is the Cars for Kids commercial.
Right.
Which is, and then, you know, and I love children, but you wind up not liking these little fellas.
Yeah.
But they spend so much. They're such a huge advertiser. Who knows how much they spend just at this one radio station, the one where our main radio station in New York.
Oh, it's going to be a lot.
At WABC. Who knows how much they spend there? And they may spend something on Fox, or they may not, but I mean...
Catchy tune, huh?
And it's just, I'm not giving my car to them. First of all, I'm not going to give my car to some kid.
That's the first thing.
All right, please welcome now from the great state of Arizona, Senator John McCain. Good morning, Senator McCain.
As always, I agree with you. That is, talk about fingernails on a chalkboard. That commercial, I've gotten to the point now where I turn the volume all the way down as I hear it start. They ought to shoot the guy, the head of whatever ad agency that made
it. No, Senator. No, we shouldn't shoot him, Senator. They should maybe give him a timeout. How does that sound?
Yeah. I think shoot him.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
Psychos is coming up. And we have four psychos. Deirdre Imus, Dagan Maydell, Nat Candido, and Dr. Bill Evans, the weather guy.
Head psycho.
So they're all going to whine about something that's upset their whole lives. All that, so... And then, we'll move on. So,
yeah.
How about Travis Mills?
Oh, man. Wow. Oh, man. Really impressive.
It's on the label. So.
Yeah, it is.
Tony and Rob, as I told you last hour, sold out the Tarrytown Music Hall.
Mm-hmm.
And a standing room situation. People, there were fights outside, people trying to get in.
Yeah.
So, I think probably exaggeration
a little bit.
Ooh, yeah.
A few old ladies.
It was sold out, I'll tell you that. So I'm very happy about that and why am I happy about it?
Well,
because it makes me look good.
Of course.
Damn right.
That's what I'm talking about. So.
Good job, guys.
And on Psychos, I was going to complain about DirecTV, but I couldn't contain myself.
Oh, really?
So I already did that. But
that was your version of try to hold it in?
Oh, man, I'm telling you. What a frustrating. And, I've been a loyal DirecTV customer since 1995.
Very loyal. And
it's an awful company. Oh my God! Well, it's not may not be an awful company, but the way they their customer situation. But then I didn't know. If you call them, you don't have to go through all that. You can just say, press O, get operator or something. Is that right, Dagan?
Yeah. If you say operator or attendant, they should pick up. Most automated phone lines do that.
Over and over. Just keep saying it.
Hey, Bernard?
Yes,
Lou?
Yes.
Can you dial a phone there? I mean, can we call somebody on the air?
Yeah, we could do that.
This will be good.
The only problem is you can't put them on the air unless you get their permission.
Right.
So we can't.
You won't have to tell them that for a while. You won't get somebody for a while.
Yeah, it won't be a problem. The automation system won't care.
Just send them a letter first.
Stupid rules.
Well, I'm going to try it today and find out. Because I could have avoided hours of... And it's, oh, man. But it's, of course, if that's all you have to complain about...
Yeah.
Well, ...is that you couldn't get through to your DirecTV opera... I mean, come on.
Well, at least you know. But that's it. That's what you're dealing... That's where you are, so don't apologize
for it.
The
iWorld.
Yeah, exactly.
We want
to
hear
about. But it's embarrassing to be like that.
But most companies are like that.
They are?
The most, yes.
All of them.
Delta Airlines, your flight's canceled. You have to call and leave them a message, and they call you back an hour and a half later. Sitting at the airport. Well, no flight.
You have to do what Dagan suggests. Either keep hitting zero or just say operator, 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 customer service, and then just keep saying it.
Well, they and they're not. But then you have to know all this stuff, you know. What your account number is, what your well, who knows that stuff? Nobody.
Right.
And they really make it difficult for you. So, and you know they're trying to sell you. I mean, I bought two DirecTV receivers.
Right.
Putting them in my horse trailer. I blew my horse trailer. It was beautiful, by the way.
And you have to be among the leaders in individual DirecTV units.
Yeah.
I mean.
Shout out to Outlaw Conversions there in Stephenville, Texas. Man, they put together you can actually live in this thing. I mean, live there.
Yeah.
Just forget, sell your house.
So. Drive around.
Anyway, 9 minutes after the hour, what's coming up with the business, Dagan?
Getting rid of your double chin. It's a business story.
That's something you're interested in, Ashley, or not?
Well, I was just thinking as I'm looking down, maybe I should pick my head up like that.
Yeah. Well, but, you look fine now.
So. Oh, well, thank you.
And Warner, what happened in sports? Anything?
Yeah, the Warriors and the Hawks became the first teams to win 50 games this year, and the Knicks became the first team to lose 50 games this year.
Yeah.
And we have three more teams into the NCAA tournament: Manhattan, Northeastern, Wofford. And the tournament begins 1 week from tonight. The selections will be on Sunday, where, again, at least two or three teams will say, hey, what about us?
Yeah, sure.
So,
well, I always figure there's something going on there with that selection process. But what do you have, Bernard?
Well, speaking of psychos, we have your friend James Carville amusingly trying to defend Hillary Clinton. And we're gonna get to the bottom of President Obama lifting these lyrics from Jay-Z at the Selma speech.
Well, you were gonna tell me that during the last briefing. We never got to it.
Right, we were very late.
Well, can't you do it now?
No, we're gonna do it at the bottom of the hour. We're gonna tease
here.
The audience and
hold on a minute.
And you're gonna enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. It's gonna be great.
Well, what if we run out of time this hour?
Well, we better.
Oh, we'll do it first. How about that?
Good compromise.
Yeah, but you promised us last time you didn't do it. You had some other stuff on that we could have done without.
No, that was good stuff. Bill Cosby and his PJs.
That was very good.
Are you kidding?
That was good, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think he's thinking about, by the way?
I think he's lost his mind.
Well, he has, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, time for the news now. Here at 11 minutes after the hour. And with that, Connor McShane, morning, Connor.
Morning, I'm in. There's criticism from Democrats, starting with the vice president moving down from there, and there's dismissal from the Iranians over this open letter signed by 47 Republican senators. And the letter warns Iran that any nuclear deal they cut with President Obama could expire the day he leaves office. In Iran, the state media reporting the foreign minister dismissed it as a propaganda ploy. Now, the senators are upset, basically, that they haven't been consulted on all this.
God.
Jen Psaki at the State Department says that's not necessary.
Hello.
The Constitution assigns the authority to the executive to negotiate these deals with foreign partners. And so implying that Congress has a role that was implied in this letter is inaccurate.
Don't have to go through the Congress, says Ms. Psaki at the State Department. But anyway, the Republican Senator Tom Cotton out of Arkansas is the guy who started all of this, and you had 47 senators signing the letter. The
front page of New York Daily News calls them traitors.
Oh, really?
Yep. Big headline.
These senators, yeah, for not for getting involved in the president's negotiations.
What out?
U.S. Ambassador Mark Lippert, the guy who was attacked over in South Korea, he says officials will take a hard look at security procedures there and then make a decision on any changes that are needed. He left the hospital today after 5 days of treatment because of the knife attack that he was the subject of. There was a man screaming about unification of North and South Korea that attacked him with a knife, but he says he feels pretty darn good, all things considered. That's how he put it. And a top Texas high school football recruit is now saying he finds a racist fraternity video, quote, disturbing, and he's changed his mind about attending the University of Oklahoma. Now, this video has been out there. It's been in the news, the Sigma Alpha Epsilon fraternity, OU chapter, with a racial slur, even a reference to lynchings with these students on a bus. God. The football players, Gene DeLance, spoke with a couple of Dallas area stations and university officials shutting down the fraternity house on campus as a result of all this. And this guy says, no, changed his mind, not going to go to Oklahoma anymore.
Where's he going?
I don't know. I don't know. But
anywhere
he
else.
Not going to go there.
Now, 13 after the hour here on the I'm Smiling program. A business report is sponsored by Lindamood Bell Learning Centers. They help students learn to read and comprehend to their potential. And here with it is Dagan McDowell. Morning, Dagan.
Good morning, sir. Dow Futures down 113 points right now, almost reversing that 139-point gain from yesterday. And think about this. Get a shot and get rid of your big old fat double chin. Well, that is in the cards. A Food and Drug Administration panel voting to recommend approval of an injectable drug to treat submental fat, commonly known as a double chin. The drug is made by this company, Cathera. It reduces the localized fat deposits under your chin. Really, the only thing you can do alternatively until now is liposuction, which is about $5,000.
Or how about not eating like a pig? Yeah,
stuffing your face.
Diet, how does that sound?
Diet doesn't necessarily get rid of it.
It's what starts it.
You could be very thin, and once you have it, you're still going to have that big kind of like scarf of fat under your...
Did you ever take Mucinex?
Me?
Yes.
Have you taken it?
Yeah.
I take it all
the time. Make your mouth dry?
Yes, very.
Oh, man, I took a couple of Mucinex this morning because I'm allergic to everything.
Right.
And now my mouth is so dry, I can hardly talk.
Mm. Common side effect.
I probably shouldn't take it in the morning then, right?
Probably not.
Speaking of double chins.
And Teresa Burney from Staten Island, she's she does the eye man's hair every morning, and a lot of other people as well.
Yeah, it takes a village.
And she's an eye.
Oh, she does a lot of other people's hair. I see. That's different.
That funny, Tony?
Yeah. No, not at all. I mean, you look good.
Terrific.
So, but her cat broke its knees. That's what Carly told me.
Yeah, unfortunate.
Got in trouble with the mob.
Yes.
Is that what happened?
The cat tore all of the ligaments in both knees, I think.
How?
Chasing a mouse out a fifth floor window.
Two out of the four.
What did the cat do to do that?
I don't know. It fell somehow. But it's like $5,000 to $7,000 to get it fixed, I think.
Mm. Some rehab like for that, I wonder.
Huh. Well,
cats have knees?
It fell. Fell from where?
I don't know.
Damn it, we want answers.
Yeah, we got
to
get
no, but I mean, have you ever heard of that?
Clumsy cat? No.
Aren't cats supposed to fall off of stuff and land on their feet, don't they?
That's what they say.
Maybe that's what happened.
Too much catnip.
Plus the nine lives and everything. Doesn't make any sense. None of this makes sense.
These excuses, I mean.
That's what it is.
I have people who work for us at the ranch who've had 9 grandmothers die. You know, so you get a few days off.
Honestly, if this is an excuse, this is really a good one.
Yeah, so.
It's not. It's the truth. She told me yesterday, 2 days ago, I think. Yesterday.
I mean, every time I turn around, Bismarck's going to Puerto Rico, was another relative of his died. I mean, nobody has a... He's related to everybody in Puerto Rico. Have you lost your mind? My grandmother died. He's had 7 grandmothers die.
Oh, my second cousin Hector.
Yeah.
Checked out, bro.
And here's another one. It's like Lucia out at the ranch. I love her to death. But I don't care. Does she have a relative, for example? Yeah. A distant relative. Somebody she maybe hadn't seen in 30 years. If that person is in the hospital any place in America, she wants off to go see him.
Right.
Well, what?
Very supportive.
Well, whatever.
The
cat broke its knees. That
too
really
much.
Is.
Ashley, what are you reporting this
morning? Sounds like a mob hit, doesn't it, for the cat?
Yeah.
Maybe it was Jeff Galooly or something. Taylor Swift going on world tour in May, and she's decided that the best thing to do is probably be safe and insure her legs, which some of these celebrities do, and they're insured for $40 million. She
says I don't think the deal's gone down yet. I think they were speculating.
They're still doing the paperwork, apparently, according to that. But she thought they may be worth $1 million, so she was a little off.
That's what the cat should have done.
It was 17 after the hour. Psychos with Bill Evans, did with Dagan and Nat Candido is coming up. Larry Flint's here this morning. Larry, what are you talking about?
Bill Cosby's video.
Oh, let me hear this.
Well, he's made this video to his fans where he plugs his upcoming date in West Virginia, which I guess is the only place he can still perform, because down there they're pretty loose about who you can have sex with. He stages a phone call where he gives all the particulars for the date and then says, "You know, I'll be hilarious." Yeah, you're right about that, Cos. You are hilarious. Faking a phone call to an imaginary DJ on a non-existent radio station so you can sell tickets to your gig so the audience will be more than a campfire? That's a scream. That's better than your Noah bit. Wow, he's finally lost it. Red satin pajamas is a bold move for a 77-year-old man, considering satin isn't all that absorbent. It is a little strange he's still in his jammies in the afternoon. Usually he has to spike a woman's drink before he gets ready for bed. Yeah. And he sent the video out with a note, "I'm far from finished," which means you're still going to have to keep an eye on your cocktails, ladies. Either that or make sure the bartender sticks a Red Bull in it. Or even better, order a double espresso with 10 shots of 5-hour energy. Or pop a Benny before you go to the concert. I know when I'm trying to get a woman to have sex with me, I don't slip a Mickey in her drink. I do like Oprah. I slip her the keys to a brand new Mercedes. Speaking of Mickeys, who's Cosby's favorite Disney character? Woody? No. Dopey? No. Sleeping Beauty.
After the hour, time for sports, sponsored by Hackensack University Medical Center. Thank you, Larry. Anyway, here with the sports is Warner Wolf. Morning, Warner.
Morning, Iron Man. Coming to you from the NJDiet.com studio. Warriors win. They go 50-12. The Hawks win. They go 50-13. The best young player in the game, 21-year-old Anthony Davis, 43 points. The Pelicans beat the Bucks. And in Denver, the Nuggets beat the Knicks by 28. The Knicks dropped to 12-50. Here was the end of the game, called by Mike Breen and Clyde Frazier of MSG.
Rough outing once again as the Knicks lose for the seventh straight time here in Denver.
There's the brain trust that has to try to get this train back on the right track.
Man, they sound despondent, don't they? Honestly, God, they need Travis Mills to cheer them up.
Yes. After the game, here was Knick forward Jason Smith, the only Knick to play in all 62 games.
You just have to keep continuing to play hard. Whoever's out there on the floor, we're going to keep subbing guys in that want to play. If you don't want to play, you're going to sit on the bench.
Yeah, that's it. NFL in that AFC East. While the Bills get LeSean McCoy and the Dolphins get Ndamukong Suh, the Jets have made a bid for Browns free agent quarterback Brian Hoyer. What a 1-2 punch. Brian Hoyer and Geno Smith. Man, that'll scare him. And the final weekly NCAA AP poll, this is before the conference postseason play, 31-0 Kentucky number 1, 28-3 Duke moves up to 2, and 28-2 Virginia, who lost to Louisville by 2 points, drops to 3. Villanova and Arizona remain the same.
All right, Warner, thanks. 21 after the hour here in the I Miss the Morning program. I know Warner wasn't done, but
oh yeah,
he got to the point there where it was just not even worthy of Sports Center.
Oh, hey, come on.
What's coming up in a briefing, Bernie?
We have Obama lifting the Jay-Z lyrics.
Uh-oh. Evans is going to be on Psychos. Here's one of his my favorite songs.
And now on Fox Business.
So, 24 till the hour here at the Amherst Morning Program. So, I called the druggist, a pharmacist over there, Thomas Drug, my boy, and to get something recommend for us to get this congestion that I have. So, he recommends this Mucinex. And, it's just terrible because it dries your mouth out. And it says, so I say to my wife, by the way, it's time for Psychos. Starring, well, Deirdre, I'm taking me down. That's Candido and Bill Evans. Hey, Bill, are you there?
Hey, Billy.
Hey.
What, Bill? Come on, you got to bring the noise here.
Bill.
A lot of excitement, Bill.
Where's Bill?
Hey.
Well, Bill's just not working for Bill. Well, that's fine.
It was just there.
So what the hell happened to
Bill? I know. Psycho. What happened to Bill?
So I say to my wife, thinking that she would commiserate with me, that my and even okay. Dagan suggested I
I'm
ask
here.
Her
there he is.
About being dried out, and you're just
dried
you're
out.
Really you're just a nightmare. I love you to death.
No.
By the
no,
way,
no.
You
I
look.
Went up.
Fabulous.
Right,
very nice.
Thank you. So,
she started screaming at you for no reason.
No.
You were just letting her know.
Did I scream?
You were just letting her know the side effects of the pill, and she starts going crazy on you.
You're getting on the wrong side of this argument, big guy.
I had your side last week. Oh, we got to be big again.
Connell and Dagan, you were sitting right here, and so were you, Nat. This is a male thing, then, and I'm going to call it a male thing, because you'll do that to your wife that you're with.
What is this?
Well, that's
not going to happen. She'll say one thing and not agree with you, and you'll say, stop screaming at me. And she's not screaming. That's what he does. You just said I wasn't yelling.
You were getting a little nasty.
No. Being firm with you losers is not yelling. Thank you, Dagan. Yeah. Exactly. That's a loser that says that. We have no idea what this woman has to cope with every day in terms of your medical management.
Gotcha.
In terms of the litany of things.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm staying alive, you bastard.
But, honey, you complain about the levels of congestion on a, like, almost minute-to-minute basis sometimes at home. So now you have congestion gone. So now you're complaining because you have a dry mouth. So now we're going to hear that, the levels of dry mouth all day.
But he what?
He's coughing up stuff in a handkerchief going, honey, look at this. Does this exactly. Look bad? Is this worse than it was? Is this a better color?
Do you do that?
No, I don't do that.
Yes, he does now.
Dagan is a liar.
And then
time for Psychos. Let's start with Bill. Are you there?
Yes, I am.
All right. Hey, Bill.
Welcome to this edition of Psychos. What are you whining about, Bill?
Well, you know, we are approaching hurricane season.
Yeah.
And our mayor and the city council pretty much still unprepared for the next hurricane. In our last snowstorm, all they talked about was climate change. They keep talking about climate change. They have to do something about climate change. You know, the climate is always changing. We had our coldest February in the last 40 years, fifth coldest February ever, 10th coldest month ever. So they keep harping on climate change. But they have done nothing to prepare us for the next hurricane. In the last hurricane, we lost power, we couldn't get gas, you couldn't get money out of an ATM, we had flooding in the tunnels, we had flooding all over Manhattan, and the power was out for a month in Lower Manhattan. They have done nothing
to
protect
the
minute. Citizens.
Do you live in Lower Manhattan?
I live on the Upper East Side.
And Bill, climate change is real, and hurricanes sometimes are a result of that, with the violent, erratic weather patterns. Mr. Weatherman.
Well, yeah, but he's just saying that they're not prepping.
He has a legitimate complaint that the city.
No, my point is this. I have testified before the City Council of New York twice and told them 2 years before Hurricane Sandy, you need to make sure that gas stations have generators so you can get gas. You need to put something in the tunnel. You need to cover the subways. What did they cover the subways with? Plywood.
Maybe so you should be running for mayor then so you can handle all this.
So taxpayers end up paying, everybody else, you end up paying millions of dollars for mistakes.
Well, how about actually sounding upset about it rather than sounding like, well, a weatherman?
You sound like you're reading one of your children's books right now.
Are you reading that? I mean, you just sound like it's pathetic. Right.
You're not bringing a noise,
Bill.
Supposed to
be a psycho. I'm not
a psycho.
No.
You
sound
like a sex phone operator.
Good point, bad delivery.
Well, quiet.
That's a C-.
Would have been much better if you were on complaining about not being able to find, a parking place.
No.
True.
Or that is DirecTV went out so we can't watch porn during the hurricane.
That'll be good.
All right, Bill Evans whining about the city not being ready. Well, that's just him. Shut up about it.
There
Don't
you go.
Worry
I think
about
it. Was a really bad idea.
There's Dagan McDowell. What's on your mind?
Over the weekend, I sat by a communal pool and saw half a dozen wild animals. I mean, children nearly destroy thousands and thousands of dollars of patio furniture. It looked like a soccer match melee.
What?
So where was this? Right. One kid ripped a hole in a giant hedge trying to climb through it down in Florida at an apartment complex. Where were the parents? You know where they were? They were sitting right there. Two mothers, neck deep in their third bottle of wine, men smoking, fat sitting around. Wow. Kids are running roughshod. And the worst part of it, security guard came out and reprimanded the children, and the mother yelled at him, started cursing at him, wanted to know what his problem was. You know what her problem is? You know what this country's problem is? That these parents act like their children are so special, they're so terrific, and so exceptional that the rules do not apply to them. It's why we have a generation of narcissistic losers growing up in this country. And you know what I take great, great excitement in?
What?
I know that her 40-year-old sons are going to wind up living back with her. That's after they get out of prison for mortgage fraud. Oh, and you know all that expensive jewelry you're wearing? Well, you know what? Your pregnant daughter's meth head boyfriend's going to break into your house and steal that jewelry. And oh, by the way, lady, check your medicine cabinet because your Vicodin's gone too. So enjoy your wine while you can.
There's a hurricane
she
coming.
Is right. They just released a study too about that
That's
children
right.
that grow up where the parents overpraise them and they have this they grow into this sense of entitlement, irresponsible, and like I call it, lazy, sloppy parenting. Because we wouldn't do that as parents. We wouldn't allow Wyatt to do anything like that.
No.
Never have. So I have witnessed that, too, where we're mortified, too, at lazy, sloppy parenting while the parents are getting sloshy drunk, and they act like their kids are an inconvenience.
She cursed out the security guard.
But my favorite line from that was, the guy going to prison for mortgage fraud.
It's a slippery slope when you let the kids break the furniture by the pool.
Well, all right.
That's where they're going.
We're in the middle of psychos here. Now, what are you bitching about other than everything?
Well, like we were in the restaurant this weekend and the weekend before that. And
which restaurant?
One of them was El Chico.
Okay. What about
another one was Yummy Yummy. The restaurant isn't the point here, I-Man. It's people coming
Where
in.
Are we?
With their families. You'll have, like, we witnessed one time, and the three of us couldn't believe it. You mean what? And they come in, and these two couples, young couples in their late 20s or 30s, and they all get on their cell phones.
Well, that was at the Four Seasons.
On their cell
awesome.
Phones in the restaurant. They can't even look at each other.
I hate it.
Is
you
that,
see these families
insane.
Out to dinner, and they're all looking down on their phones. The kids are watching movies on their iPads.
Right.
There's no, like, communication amongst people anymore.
Yeah. Why did you?
Know?
You...
And they give them their iPad so the kids shut up. What kind of parenting is that?
I would take that over those urchins tearing up stuff, though, in the restaurant.
Yeah, but on that point, Dagan, those kids are just kids do that kind of stuff.
Everyone's dummy out.
Not in public, they don't. Not in public. Children are not allowed to act like that. I wasn't allowed to go out and eat dinner in public until I was 12, until I knew how to behave.
Did they still have the muzzle on you?
That's because the restaurant was so far down.
So you're upset about what now?
They should ban it. This is crazy. And then you could hear people on their phones with their conversations about making a doctor's appointment in the elevator, too. Another thing, New Yorkers, don't get in the elevator with other people on your cell phone making a doctor's appointment talking about your yeast infection. I don't want to hear it.
It's so random.
You know what, I always do? I always get in close because the elevator starts going up, and I go, your call's going to drop 1, 2 right now. And it always ends.
By the way, this is from a woman who, when you has her phone in her hand 24/7.
No, I don't.
Who, when she's...
Well, why are you saying that? That's not true.
Because...
That is not true.
And who's on a computer all of the time.
Well, I am on a computer, Lex. I'm doing work.
And when I try to talk to you, they won't look up from the computer.
That's not true. Oh, if I'm working or writing or reading research, which I have to do a lot of...
You were...
You have plenty of time to talk to her. She's working.
Matt, I'm working.
Oh, you fat...
Thanks,
have you lost your mind?
It's the truth.
But he can't just say, excuse me, honey,
what
can
is,
we just talk
said?
For a moment? Or I have something to
you
tell you.
You won't do it.
No, you don't do that.
When
Instead,
I say, excuse me.
You just start talking, and then you're like, I can't believe how rude you are to me. Yeah.
You probably just start rambling on like you do here in the studio, and nobody's listening, ever.
Man. It's 14 till they are in the middle of psychos. Time now.
What happened to Bill?
I think he left.
Bill, did you have anything you wanted to add to this?
No, this is good stuff, man. I could go about 40 more minutes of this.
There's Nat Candido, for some reason, went back and put on a jacket, and I like that shirt. I mean, it's a nice ensemble.
Thank you.
Right.
But he's got his top button, two buttons unbuttoned.
Oh, no, that's the normal look.
Nat
I always wear my
honey,
shirts like
Nat
this.
Nat looks good. You look really
it
good.
It isn't what you always do. It's all that hair on your...
Yeah, but that's him. He's got to go with it.
Your button's up to your neck because you have one white strand of hair on your chest. What does that say about you?
Oh, man.
I don't see that we would look at this as an opportunity to disparage me, do you?
No, I'm just
trying
to defend myself.
He's going after you now because he went after Deirdre earlier, and she's scarier to him than you are.
Just trying to, you know, level the playing field. I'm complaining about, like, you know, on the weekends when you make plans with your friends or your family or your girlfriend, and it's 7 o'clock. That's when you're supposed to be going out, right?
Sure.
And they're late, okay? I hate people that are late. Because I plan, if I have plans, I'm planning my entire day up until that point. Mm-hmm. Because I want to go right, all right, I could do this, this, and this, and this time, shower, relax, and then it's 7 o'clock, right?
Shower.
Because I don't like to really put my pants on until I'm ready to go out, because I sweat a lot. So I'm trying to,
oh,
I plan.
No, 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 stop. You don't like to put your pants
Whoa.
On.
What
no.
about your underwear?
Because you sweat a lot.
I'm around, if I'm going out and I'm like, say I'm wearing like dress shoes and I'll have my dress socks on up to my knees with my underwear and a t-shirt just hanging out.
Oh, that's hot.
What kind of underwear do you wear? Do you wear the tidy whiteies? Are you like a
No,
boxer
I don't wear tidy whiteies. I have
how
boxer
much,
briefs.
How much
support
do you
yet breathing, you know what
how
I mean?
Much, how much do you sweat?
I sweat a lot. And then I'm waiting and I'm dressed and I'm sweating because I'm pissed off.
If he's wearing khakis, we're talking about a big crotch stain.
No, I don't have swamp ass or anything like
this
that.
Is great.
Okay? But I'm saying I want to be when I get dressed, I'm ready to go out. I'm waiting around now. I'm sweating. I'm pissed. Be on time next time,
You're
please.
You're lucky they
is
show up.
Is this your girlfriend?
Yeah. Yes.
How late?
Late.
How late?
Saturday, she was an hour late, and
oh
Sunday,
God.
She was 3.5 hours
By
late.
By the way, that will never change. Trust me
on
this.
No, no,
if
no.
They're
not
late once, they're late forever.
In her defense, she had something serious come up one time.
Oh, then.
Okay? Because
her boyfriend.
She just, no, she was that. Shut up, Bernie. I'm a boyfriend, bro. I'm a boyfriend.
Psychos. Well, anyway, it's coming up on 6 minutes to the hour. There the I'm Swain program. Trying to fight off the effects of Mucinex.
Man.
It's always some stuff to bitch about, you know?
Never ends.
But,
Oh, I called DirecTV, by the way.
Yeah?
It's a bigger nightmare than you think. I can save it till the next hour. It's bad.
Oh, yeah. Say
an operator doesn't work. Pressing zero doesn't work. It says call back during regular business hours.
Oh, yeah. They're horrible.
Nice.
Man. They, man. I mean, I love DirecTV, which you, all the stuff you can watch.
Yeah.
But once you get it. But they just make it impossible. So.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, Frank Rich is coming up. And Frank's pretty much spent most of his time now producing television shows, including that Veep, what's her name, which really is funny. They've done something else. I've always liked Frank. I still like Frank. So a lot of people complain about him, who I know, because he's liberal, but
it's a free country.
Yeah. I still like Frank. Who cares what he is? I like Hannity. So come on. 5 till the hour. I'm in the morning. Buzz, of course, Bissinger, who's a terrific writer and a very nice guy, had lives a complicated life. And he wrote a confessional about
he was like a shopaholic for.
Was that what he was?
Clothing addiction for clothes.
A clothing addiction.
Yeah.
But only to Gucci, right?
He's like a wardrobe freak.
Yeah.
Right.
Well.
And all leather stuff, and he even confessed, I believe, to wearing. Items that were designed for women, right?
Yes. Right. Yeah. Originally designed
that way.
Wanted
to feel pretty.
Right? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well.
Hey, he. Exactly. Who among us hasn't?
Or that's
hasn't what?
First stone.
Done what Buzz has done.
Or something
similar. Right, Connell?
Something similar, Bernie. Right?
Worn women's clothes?
Just on the weekends, I mean.
Okay, I haven't. Let's start there. Have you, Rob?
Really?
No.
Marv?
Tony?
No.
Dagan? Well, Dagan, you are a woman.
Right, she is a woman.
So far.
But I'm wearing men's briefs right now. So.
Right.
See?
That's right.
Those cuts both ways.
How about you, Warner? You ever worn women's clothes?
No.
So you don't consider panties women's clothes?
How about you, Ashley?
I'm British. What do you think?
You probably have women's clothes on now.
I certainly do. They feel great.
Ladies and gentlemen, Imus in the morning.
Frank Rich is coming up. And we'll talk to Frank about, I don't know what we'll talk to Frank about yet.
Something.
But Frank produces, he's the executive producer of Veep on HBO with Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Dreyfus, which is really funny.
New season next month.
Oh, man. And he does some other stuff, too. Plus, a boy can write. Now, does he have these Finocchio pansy positions on issues? Some, yeah. So, but I like Frank, that's all.
That's it.
Frank was loyal and not a phony, at least with me. So, and so we're going to talk with Frank Riz because, where's that boy coming from? Doesn't it seem like Maureen Dowd had a pretty good column about the Clintons, about, man, that just seems so like last century, doesn't it?
Well, it was. It still is.
I mean, I don't think I'd just, I mean, who wants to go through that again with them?
Well, the Bill part, I wouldn't mind. But the Hillary part?
Oh, God.
We can get a hold of his emails and get into some of that stuff.
Well, that's, I'm even lost interest in that. I mean, it's just, I mean, we need fresh meat.
Yeah, that's right.
So we need somebody else who's got a hideous, you know, they all have a hideous resume. And we just need somebody else to, we just need new jokes, new whatever.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can make fun of all of them if we have to, right?
Then Jeb Bush. Oh, God.
Same thing.
It's he looks like a suit dummy over there at, where's that place that sells the three suits for, you buy one suit, you get five free?
Joseph A. Bank.
Joseph A. Yeah. Bank. He looks like a Joseph A. Bank suit dummy.
Nice man.
Well, I'm sure he is.
Very.
But, man, I just, I just can't do it.
Yeah, you need something
people,
fresh.
Those people are just awful. Well, in case you missed it, we had the wonderfully inspiring Travis Mills in here this morning. Yeah. Kids in the 82nd Airborne in Afghanistan. Lost parts of both legs and arms. And it's got these prostheses now, which I can't say, of course. And the most marvelous, positive personality of anybody I've ever met.
Yeah.
And an inspiration for these other soldiers and people. It's inspiration for everybody.
Right. That's why I guess why he's a motivational speaker.
Oh, what?
Well, I can understand that.
You can see why for sure.
He's, yeah. Plus, he's handsome.
Right.
The boy's handsome.
Yeah.
And he's got a great sense of humor.
Yeah. Self-deprecating. Well, how positive. I mean, just how do you stay that
positive?
I mean,
one time Dr. Richard Matthey, one of the foremost pulmonary specialist in the world, a great doctor up there at Yale. I was bitching to him about not being able to breathe, you know. He said, you got to play the ball where it lies. I said, you mean you can't, like, move it to a little better location?
Get a little
no.
kick, yeah.
No, you can't. He said, you got to stop bitching about it, too. How's that?
Well, so, it's worked out.
But you mean somebody like Travis. I mean, it's like Travis, we were talking off the air here. I actually, as I was talking to him, I didn't know whether to bring it up or not. I just trust my gut always. But you got 22, 23 or so of these soldiers that kill themselves every day. Every day. I mean, I'm complaining about taking this Mucinex that's made my mouth dry, and 22 kids are going to kill themselves today. So, and imagine though, we were talking about, I said, well, do you think you have, he's so self-effacing, Travis is, I said, do you think you have an impact? And he says, I hope I do. So, I can't imagine he wouldn't. I mean, man, that's such a great story. It's ridiculous. And then try to do something about it.
Mm-hmm.
So go to TravisMills.org. and figure out a way to help him. Like O'Reilly, one of the reasons I like O'Reilly was that boy's raised millions of dollars for these veterans and selling those chairs, you know. Well, I don't know how many of those O'Reilly sold, but he gets cut a lot of slack. He ought to be for all that stuff he does. I mean, that's really remarkable. And Hannity, too. Those guys, man, I mean, they, with their own money, and so I'm, but anyway, I just, when you get a chance, go to TravisMills.org. I mean, it's, they need some help, and you can help them, and somebody who's willing to do what he does, is there's no way to pay him back, you know. Anyway, what happened in sports last night, Warner? Anything?
Well, you have three more teams making it to the NCAA tournament, which begins a week from tonight. And the NFL salary cap strikes again. The biggest name, Darrell Revis. And the Warriors and Hawks win their 50th, and the Knicks lose their 50th.
Why would the Patriots cut Darrell Revis loose?
$20 million salary cap.
They could still bring him back.
That's more than Brady gets, I think, or close to it. You can't be paying a defensive back equal to the quarterback. No. I think that's the way they think. But they still have a chance to bring him back if no one else gives him a bigger offer. But he usually goes for the money.
What would they have to pay him?
Oh.
I mean, say the Jets want him. What would the Jets have to pay him?
Well, more than the Patriots. But the Jets do have the
That's not what I'm asking.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't say who do they have to pay him more than. Do you know the dollar amount?
$15,000. I don't know the money amount.
Okay, that's all you got to say.
Yeah.
Like, I was trying to explain to Max, my foreman down to ranch in Texas. I said, an acceptable answer is the following. I don't know. Everybody, you can't convince people of the. Nobody wants to say, I don't know. You see him on television all the time. He's mouth-breathing, talking hairdos. So, I mean, I don't know. So, and obviously you don't know.
No.
Can you find out?
No, because I'm sure the Jets wouldn't tell the Patriots what they're going to offer.
I'm coming over there.
Right.
That's the bottom line.
I'm coming over there. What floor are you on?
Oh, wait a minute. Let me tell the sales department.
And Larry Flint's back. Larry, what do you have?
I'm going to talk about the excuses to take off from work.
Yeah, Teresa Burney, Staten Island, the hair and makeup person, mostly hair.
Mm-hmm.
Does she do makeup, too?
Hair.
No.
Okay. She's one of my favorite people. I love her. But she's not here today, and you know why she's not here? Because according to Carly... isn't that what she told her? Her cat broke her knees?
Broke his knees, yes.
Okay. Well, cats don't have knees. That's what so is. Do they?
Sure they do. Well, yeah.
Yes. Apparently.
Poor thing.
But even if the cat, what did the cat do with the knees?
It tore its ligaments in both knees.
Both?
Okay.
Well, two out of four.
Why would that mean you'd have to take off work?
If you're a cat? Oh, Teresa, right.
Yeah.
To nurse the...
Nurse what?
Cat back to health.
Maybe go to
the
vet.
No, take the cat to the vet.
Well, that might be it.
Well, maybe.
And drop the cat off at the vet and say, hey, fix my cat.
It's your knees here.
Fix my pussy.
She wanted to be the first to sign the cast.
First of all, you were sitting there in your car saying that.
Of course, everybody.
I just said it for you.
You dirty old.
I know what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
14 after the hour here on the Iverson Morning Program.
Right. Took almost all morning.
All right, let's do some news. We'll get to
come on.
Stock stuff with Dagan and Ashley and sports and all that. Bernie with a briefing. But here's Connell McShane with the news. Morning,
Guy, man. So reports now saying 62 people injured. No one killed, though, that Amtrak train slamming into a tractor trailer that was stuck on the tracks in Halifax, North Carolina. There was a state trooper helping the driver of the tractor trailer to try to make a left turn across the tracks, but the truck couldn't do that. And authorities say during the several minutes they were there on the tracks trying to get the truck turned, there was no warning of the approaching train. So the investigation will continue there.
Nobody killed, but 62 injured. Vice President Joe Biden, upset, not happy at all with his former colleagues in the Senate. He released a statement yesterday saying he's offended that 47 Republican senators have written a letter to the leadership of Iran, saying any nuclear deal signed with President Obama could expire when he leaves office. Biden says it's just an effort to undercut the president. And the letter, by the way, was written by a freshman senator, Tom Cotton of Arkansas, and signed by a total of 47 Republicans. Here's the president's reaction to all this.
I think it's somewhat ironic to see some members of Congress wanting to make common cause with the hardliners in Iran. It's an unusual coalition.
He says he'll focus on whether he can get a deal done or not, not all of this back and forth with the Congress. And it's just an awful story out of Argentina. Authorities say a French Olympic gold medal swimmer, Camille Muffat, and an Olympic boxer, Alexis Vastine, among 10 people who were killed yesterday. Two helicopters crashed. It was a remote area of Argentina. They were there filming a show, a reality show that airs in Europe called Dropped, where they have two teams that they leave to survive in some of the toughest terrains on Earth. So they had to go, apparently, in these helicopters to get there, and the helicopters went down. So horrible story there.
Dropped.
Yes, I mean, that would be, well, actually, the helicopters collided with each other.
Then they dropped.
Yes, they would have dropped. He was the co-creator of The Simpsons, then made a midlife career shift to philanthropy, Sam Simon. He died yesterday at a long battle with cancer, 59 years old, had worked as a writer for Taxi and Cheers and some other shows, The Tracy Ullman Show, and helped to launch The Simpsons in 1989, later establishing the Sam Simon Foundation, which he had rescued dogs from animal shelters and training them to assist the disabled. So anyway, 59 years old, he died yesterday. And Cardinal Egan, who died last week, his funeral will be today, this afternoon here in New York. And he was 82 years old. There was a public viewing yesterday and early this morning before the funeral.
Let's see if de Blasio shows up on time for his funeral.
Oh, my God. Wow, de Blasio was late for the St. Patrick's Day parade the other day out in the Rockaways. Yeah, yep. Which is...
Why? How late?
At least a half hour late.
Like half the parade.
The parade. He showed up, joins the parade in progress, and they all start booing him, and they're lucky they didn't start chucking.
How did he get elected?
And good question.
They were chanting, worst mayor ever. It's not the first time he's been late in the Rockaways. Remember, they had a memorial for that plane crash?
Yep.
And he showed up late for that, so they don't like him out there very much. After these two incidents. So.
17 after the hour, time for business news. Sponsored by Pillars Boilers. And here with that is Dagan McDowell, who was great during Psychos.
Oh, man, psychotic.
Uh-huh.
My favorite line was... when he gets out of prison because of mortgage fraud. I don't know why that means. And what's going on in the world of business?
Good morning, sir. Not much good news to report. The Dow futures are off by 181 points at the moment after a triple-digit gain yesterday. And the future of our children, let's talk about that. Burger King has dropped fountain drinks from its kids' menus and no longer pitches sodas as part of their kids' meals. Burger King making the move quietly last month following Wendy's and McDonald's. But guess what? If you want it for your children, you can still get a soda with your kids' meal if you want their teeth to fall out and them to be fat.
That's good. It's very good. I like the way you say fat.
Fat. 18
after the hour. Have you done sports yet, Warner?
No.
You want to do it?
Sure.
All right, first let me find out what Ashley's got. Ashley?
Well, talking of fast food, McDonald's in Japan is really suffering right now because of a series of food contamination scandals. They found pieces of vinyl. One, I think, chicken nugget had a screw in it. So, insert joke. Same store sales are down like 30%. So they've just responded to all of this by creating an app that you can complain through. And they're like, what the heck are you thinking? Why don't you just let people email or have a hotline or something? So they're just kind of stumbling from bad to worse for McDonald's in Japan.
By the way, I'd like to take this opportunity to apologize to you publicly for replacing you on the Psychos panel with Bill Evans.
Right.
Yes.
Who sucked to suck to a degree no one's ever sucked other than Chinga Chavin on this program. So.
Wow.
19 after the hour, time for sports, sponsored by Pillars Boilers. Don't turn it into Sports Center.
No, no.
But tell me what's going on. Here's Warner Wolf. Morning, Warner.
Hi, morning, I'm in. Coming to you from the NJDiet.com studio. So at Manhattan, Northern, Eastern, and Wofford, all winning the conferences last night. Seven teams now in the NCAA tournament beginning 1 week from tonight after the brackets are selected Sunday. Warriors and Suns both win their 50th game of the year as the Knicks lose their 50th game, dropping to 12-50, losing to the Nuggets in Denver by 28 points. After the game, Derek Fisher blamed the loss on the high altitude in Denver.
What?
A lot of guys that haven't played in this building before struggle from an energy standpoint to keep pushing themselves, and that's difficult to do here.
Oh, man.
Played any building.
What a stretch.
Oh, man.
Woo! Salary cap strikes again. Patriots passed on all-pro defensive back Darrell Revis and his $20 million option. The Texans released their all-time wide receiver Andre Johnson. And Broncos starting tight end Julius Thomas, 24 touchdowns in the last 2 years, favorite target of Peyton Manning. He becomes a free agent.
It's 21 after the hour here on the Ivan Sutter Morning Program. A shout-out to Randy Bloomer and the people of Bloomer Trailers. I paid for the trailer, by the way. Mm-hmm. I try to get it free or try to scam it, you know, because why it's doing so well and all that. By the way, Wyatt's got the big showdown, not this Saturday, but a week from Saturday. Mm-hmm. Wyatt and John Douch are tied for first after 11 rodeos and high school rodeo in Texas. And John Douch is last year's Texas state champion. And he's Wyatt's team roping partner, a couple years older than Wyatt. But Wyatt and John are tied for first, and one of them is going to be the champion. But they're both so far ahead of everybody else. Turn that off, goddammit.
What the hell?
What is that?
What's going on here? Good song.
Well, I'm not interested in him playing it now, though.
No, it was off Guns' computer.
Excuse me for taking the Lord's name in vain. I don't know why I do that. I try not to, but I just do. So. I feel bad about it. I know it offends many of you.
Yeah.
But it's just the way it is. Anyway, what was I saying?
John Douch and Wyatt, tied for first. They're so far ahead.
All I meant, the one of them will be champion, one will be reserve champion.
Tony's listening.
But, man, that's the Crockett, Texas. That's a big deal. And a shout-out to Eddie Dyson, who's the president of Region 9. He does such a good job, it's ridiculous. It's all volunteer, but they ought to pay him. That's so good. Anyway, back to Bloomer Trailer. So I got my new Bloomer Trailer. And a beautiful trailer. And Outlaw Conversion, shout out to them. And Grant Kay at Great West Trailers. They built the inside of it. And, you know, you could, this is like the Four Seasons. That's a thing. So they did, and I paid them too. They did a great job. And then it's got two televisions in it. One of them's in the living room area, and another one's in the bedroom. So, and they operates off of DirecTV.
Right.
So I called. You have to call DirecTV to get your DirecTV boxes activated. It's the worst experience I've ever had in my life with any company. Jeez. Is that right, Dagan?
Yeah, it's there's a trick to getting through to a human being on DirecTV. But it's, you literally have to, when they keep asking you to put the number in, you have to hit 0000 and then finally say representative. But all I could get was a message that said, please call back during regular business hours.
Anyway, you get an automated voice that asks you, well, what's the phone number on your account? Well, I have no idea. I assumed it was Andrews Brothers, but which it turned out it was. So then you have to read the number to them, and they can't. That's an automated deal, so they read it back to you, and it's always wrong because they can't understand it. And sometimes the numbers are way off. So you have to. So you spend a considerable amount of time doing that. And then, if you know, who knows what their account number and all that stuff, and nobody knows. No. So then when you get through all of that, then you get a live person. And by the way, the live people at DirecTV are fine. In fact, they're better than fine. They're very good.
But they work for an awful, it's an awful service. I can't tell you how they suck. I mean, in fact, I'm going to have Megan today get a hold of whoever runs DirecTV and get their ass on the air here tomorrow and find out why they suck.
Yeah.
I used up 100 minutes on my OnStar car phone because, well, that's another issue. I couldn't use my cell phone because, well, whatever. The company I use sucks.
That's for another day.
And you just... So you finally get somebody on a live person, and they ask you the same information you just spent a half an hour giving this automated system. I mean, and then they tell you they don't know what they're doing. You can't get it. I mean, we finally, the guy who, Grant, who had gone back to Stephenville, that's 2.5 hours of Huntsville, he had to drive back to activate the televisions. Now, I realize, but I mean, they're a terrible company. And why do they advertise so much? I mean, what's the point of advertising DirecTV, running all these ads, getting that blimp and all this stuff, if when you try to call them, they suck? Yeah, God. It's 26 after that. They're nice to you once they get you on the phone.
Right.
It's just, you know. Oh, hi, Mr. Imus. How are you? I said, I'm not well. You know why I'm not well? Because I have to deal with you.
Right. Well, that's important.
I didn't want to take it. I'm not nasty to the people at all, believe me.
Account number, please.
But just, oh, my God. Have you done sports yet, Warner?
Yes.
Really good.
How was it?
It was one of the best of all time.
Ever. Going back to the years ago.
Well. Great lines, Warner. Really good.
Frank Rich is coming up. But now, what do you have in a briefing?
We have the tape. Hillary Clinton says she's not running for president. You keep it where it is.
You are such an idiot. Dr. Feelgood. Checking the green room, see what's going on there.
Oh, Leon.
Should be Father Jonathan Morris.
Yeah, we're here with Father John.
That's what we're here with.
Yeah, we're just talking about how his Lent's going.
This whole thing is very uncomfortable. This is probably the most painful thing of my Lent so far. 6:30 in the morning.
Well, what did you give up for Lent?
You guys are very close to me.
Don't act like it's the first time you've been between two men in the rectory.
Okay. I'm not going to say what I gave up for Lent.
Okay. Where's the plane?
Finally, somebody's asked me.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know. Okay. I don't know where it is.
To the balance of nature people, the advertisers here in the Imus & Wayne program, which, by the way, I take the balance of nature stuff. That's part of the regimen that Deirdre gives me. But you might want to get somebody to do the ads who doesn't sound 172 years old.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, since I started taking it, I feel a lot better.
That's right.
Well, where's Frank?
That'll really sell. Yep.
Frank's dead.
Yeah, he is. Time for lunch.
Time for a Bernie briefing sponsored by Pillars Boilers here at 34 minutes past the hour. Frank Rich coming up.
But before that, Bernard McGurk. Good morning, Mr. McGurk.
Morning, Mr. Imus from the NJDiet.com studios. Earlier, fine. We saw the video of Bill Cosby in his red satin pajamas telling his friends not to worry. He's doing his comedy tour. He's going to be funnier than ever. And your friend Larry Wilmore, after seeing that particular video, he had this to say about it.
And if that video wasn't creepy enough, Cosby followed it up by releasing a statement.
The 10-second video also accompanied by this message from Cosby. Dear fans, I hope you enjoy my wonderful video message that's filled with laughter. Hey, 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 I'm far from finished.
Filled with laughter? You shouldn't be filling anyone with anything, okay? It doesn't make sense.
Ooh. Back to you, I-Man.
Oh, man. 25 till the hour here in the Imus.
The morning continues after this on Fox Business.
Till the hour here in the Imus Wine Program. Please welcome now the executive producer of Veep on HBO, Julie Louis-Dreyfus, all this stuff, writes for New York Magazine, Frank Rich. Good morning, Mr. Rich.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So do you ever, I notice your five favorite songs have not changed.
Well, I haven't been asked to change them, but I'm definitely going to put, I don't know. I have to give it some thought.
Well, here's what I was going to ask you. Do you hear new music that you think that you think has the potential to become one of Frank's five faves?
Not often. Yeah. Maybe, you know, occasionally. I think one of the things about music is that you sort of hark back to what you grew up with, and that's what music's such a part of your soul in that way that it's hard for a newcomer to come along, you know, and supplant it. And I don't know. My choices, to the extent that I remember them, were pretty much rooted in my teenage and young adult years, maybe even a little before my teenage years. No, probably not. But, do you find yourself, like, thinking, you hear a great new song, and then you think, is it really going to be one of your favorites for all time? Will we even live long enough for it to get to that step?
I do. I hear stuff all the time. I love Lucinda Williams. I even like this Bruno Mars thing. All stuff. Anyway, have you seen the Larry David show?
I have. Have you?
No, sir, I haven't.
What can I tell you about it? I think he's a hilarious guy. I mean,
so do I.
Fan of Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Yeah.
And the show is essentially a two-hour-long episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm.
If you were still writing reviews in the New York Times, how would you have reviewed it? What would you have said?
I would have said sort of that. It's got some huge laughs in it. I wish some of the laughs weren't directly brought over from Curb Your Enthusiasm because the character ostensibly is different. It's incredibly well produced. It's got like 15 good actors in it besides him. And it's like an old-fashioned Broadway comedy from, like, speaking of old time, it feels like a Neil Simon comedy from 1965.
Yeah.
Of course, it doesn't make a damn bit of difference what any critic says about it because it was literally sold out before it opened. And he's not going to extend because, as I understand it, it almost reminds me of if you were performing at a Broadway show, you'd probably within 3 weeks be fighting your way to get out of it. And my guess is that he can't wait until the run ends in early June, I think it is.
But you would have given it a more positive review than the ones we...
Well, it's got... Am I crazy? I think it's... I know it got a lousy review in the Times.
Yeah.
But it got some good reviews. Like,
yeah.
In the Daily News liked it. The Post was half and half. So it hasn't been trashed, except in my old stomping grounds. But it's, you know, anyway, it doesn't matter. And that's the thing people don't understand. People give critics all this power, but, you know, I couldn't stop Phantom of the Opera. It's still running. I tried to put myself in front of the tank. I couldn't even slow it down a little bit.
16 to the hour, talking with Frank Rich, who used to be the theater drama critic for the New York Times. So, your latest column in New York Magazine.
Yeah.
Do the Democrats need a backup plan for 2016? Which I was talking earlier this morning about, and somebody had said this. I can't remember. I'd attribute it, but I can't remember who it was.
Yeah.
But, man, I can't go through the Clintons and this and Jeb Bush. I can't do it.
You know, I've been saying to people, if it really is Hillary Clinton versus Jeb Bush, just shoot me now.
Yeah.
I cannot stand it. And the other thing is, I feel they're both paper tigers. I get the feeling, you know, they're both these huge money-sucking machines. They both are, you know, taking all the money on the table in their respective parties. They're lining up the establishments of both parties, and it's, I don't know, I'm crazy. Obviously, there are voters who love both of them. I'm not one of them.
Yeah.
At least the Republicans have like 12 other choices, what everyone thinks of them. The Democrats, they don't have another candidate to run against her. They really don't. I mean, Elizabeth Warren is a fantasy of some liberals that somehow will run. She's not running. If she ran, it'd be a Massachusetts liberal in a national election. She'd be killed. But she's smart enough not to do it. And who else do they have? You know, Martin O'Malley, the former governor of Maryland.
I mean, what's wrong with Joe Biden?
There's a rhetorical question for you.
And, of course, the Clintons have got this, I guess, burgeoning foundation donation scandal and her emails. And
well, look, I think that for a long time, I've felt the Clinton Foundation thing was a potential scandal. There's not real transparency. We're now discovering that foreign governments have started giving to it again. Foreign governments, by the way, who, as others have pointed out, suppress women's rights, which is supposedly one of Hillary Clinton's biggest causes. And by the way, it's so tone deaf. The whole thing, and also, you know, the email thing is very murky. I don't think her only public explanation has been one tweet. How can someone like that run an effective presidential campaign? And you know, I just think there's one thing after another. I also was struck by the fact that they changed the name of the Clinton Foundation fairly recently to the Bill Hillary and Chelsea Clinton Foundation.
Yeah.
Just as a political move, how boneheaded can you be? It gives her ownership of any possible scandal or impropriety that turns up there.
Well, of course, that's good news as far as many of us are concerned. But
yeah.
Hey, when does Veep start again?
It starts again April 12th, fourth season. And I'm excited about it. We're still editing it, but we're ready to go with the first episodes anyway. And this season, she became president at the end of last season when the president resigned.
Yeah.
And so she's president, but also running for president because it was a short, unfinished term. And she's wondering whether she's going to have the shortest presidency since William Henry Harrison.
It's genuinely funny.
I mean, thank you.
I'm not telling you that because you're on a phone, but I mean it. It really makes me laugh. So
well, thanks. She's right. Her slogan for president is continuity with change. Blazing on the side of her campaign bus.
All right, man. Always nice to talk with you. Thank you very much.
Take care.
Frank Rich here on the Iverson of Wayne program. 12 minutes now until the hour.